How to import Salesforce contacts from a CSV file using UiPath Studio. In this example, we will create a workflow that will automatically upload contacts from a CSV file and to your Salesforce account. Let's say you already have a Salesforce account and you want to import contacts. I will be using the most common standard CSV format. Here, I have an example of a CSV file with last name, first name, phone number, and email address. Let's open UiPath Studio and create a new workflow by clicking the New Workflow box. Let's delete the default opening sequence so we can start a new one. The whole automation process will start from opening the web browser, logging into the account, and entering the data. Let's start by telling UiPath to imitate our manual actions. Let's click on the record button and click record web. You can type in the full URL in the URL box, or you can just put it salesforce.com. Let's leave everything to default. We'll use IE or Internet Explorer as our browser. Let's click open. This will open the Salesforce website automatically in Internet Explorer. Now we are in the recording mode. As you can see, there's an orange box every time we are highlighting an element in a page. That's because UiPath recognizes each element of the page in which actions can be performed. And that means the automation still works no matter where the location of the element is. Let's highlight the login button and click on it. Login using your Salesforce administrator account. Let's put in the email address. This will give you this pop-up window. Just put in the data and press enter. Let's do the same with the password. Next, let's click on the login button. Go to the Contacts tab. Click on New Contact. Let's fill in the contact information. Let's put in the required fields, which are highlighted in a red bar. Let's put in the first name and last name. For the account name, Salesforce is the default for a new Salesforce account. Let's put in the email address. Phone number. We'll just base this information from our CSV sample. Let's say we have more data to fill out, but we need to scroll to the page. We cannot do that since we are on the recording mode. Here's what we can do. You can press F2 to stop the recording mode in a few seconds, then we can scroll down the page. There, we are now ready to fill out more information. When it's complete, click Save and New. And we are ready to enter new data, but we will stop the recording now. All actions we needed for the automation process are done. Let's press Escape to stop recording and click Save and Close. Our new record sequence will be in our workflow. We can now connect the recording sequence as our start node by dragging this line to it. We are ready to test our recording, but let's close the Internet Explorer window first. Go to Execute tab and click Run button. You can also press F5 as a shortcut. By default, before performing an action, the UiPath waits for the page to start loading until the full web page is loaded. There, as you can see, UiPath automates all the actions we have taken during the recording process. There it is! The test process is complete. Let's now create an action to open our CSV file and capture data from it. In the Activities bar, search for Read CSV. Drag and drop it to the workflow. Then double-click to open it. Let's click this button to specify the location of the CSV file. And let's go back to the main window of the workflow. Let's make this as a start node. Right-click on it and select Set as Start Node. The output of this activity will be stored in a variable, which UiPath uses to store and transfer data between activities. In this case, we will use the data from the CSV file and store it in a data table format. The variable for the output value is set automatically, but let's rename it to make it more readable. Let's name it DTContacts. We're going to use this variable later on. Next, we will create an activity that will fetch the data from the CSV file. Let's find for each row in data table in the activities bar. What it does is it will perform a loop to pick up all the data from the data table in each row. Let's change the reference variable by changing this into DTContacts. While we are on this for each activity, let's give it an output by using a write line action. Let's drag it here in the body. Then type in row. Enclose the last name with quotation marks. .toString. This expression will convert the value from the last name from the header of the CSV file into a text format. Let's do some tests first. Let's hit F5 to run the current workflow. In the output window, it gives Smith and Ryan, so yeah, it works. Now we're ready to produce the output in Salesforce. Let's move this into the recorded sequence, right-click on it, and select Cut. Let's put it here, right after the New button. I am going to move the action that I wanted to be repeated inside the body of the for loop. Let's now change the manual inputted values into the value of the data table. So I'm going to change this to row first name. .toString. Let's leave the account name to Salesforce since data won't be changed for this. What I'm putting here inside the quotation is the exact letter format from the CSV file. Okay, we're done. Let's make the last changes in the workflow by connecting all the activities. Now let's rename this to Salesforce Import. We're done. Let's now see it in action. Let's execute the workflow by pressing F5. There, as you can see, with just one click, it performs the actions automatically. It logs in, and it goes to the contacts page, and enters the values from the CSV file. That's it! Now you have a solution of importing large amount of data to your Salesforce contacts or other CRM software. For more helpful tips and tutorials, go to support.uipath.com. Thanks for watching!